Who are the American Freedmen? Prelude. In order for you to understand who are the American Freedmen, we must first understand American chattel slavery. Chattel slavery in the United States was a system that allowed individuals to be treated as property and bought and sold as commodities. The institution of chattel slavery has deep historical roots in American colonies and played a significant role in shaping the nation's development until its abolition in the mid-19th century. The ties between chattel slavery and American freedmen are evident in the legacy of oppression and discrimination faced by the newly emancipated individuals and their descendants. The following timeline is meant to provide our audience with a high-level understanding of slavery and its impact on American history. The colonial period. Slavery was present in America since its inception. Slavery was present in the American colonies from the early 1600s, with Virginia introducing legal provisions for chattel slavery in the mid-1600s. The enslaved individuals were primarily of African descent, and their labor was exploited in various economic activities, including agriculture and later industries like tobacco and rice. As time would pass, other industries would rely upon enslaved labor. The development of chattel slavery. As the colonies expanded and the plantation system grew, chattel slavery became deeply entrenched in the southern states. Slavery was central to the economic prosperity of the southern colonies and later the southern states. Slavery became closely tied to the racial ideology, with African individuals being designated as the hereditary slave class. It's important to note that northern states also heavily relied on the labor of enslaved individuals in the slave trade. For example, the state of Rhode Island is documented as having the highest amount of slave voyages among the northern states. In addition, the state of New York heavily relied on the labor and wealth created by slavery, and nearly most of its institutions benefited from the system of American chattel slavery. American Revolution and Constitution. The ideals of the American Revolution, with its emphasis on freedom and equality, raised questions about the contradictions between these principles and the institution of slavery. The U.S. Constitution, adopted in 1787, included compromises that indirectly protected the institution of slavery, such as the Three-Fifths Compromise and the Fugitive Slave Clause. Note, the Three-Fifths Compromise provided slaveholding states with additional representatives in government, which had a significant impact on the political reality of the nation. Antebellum period. In the 19th century, the issue of slavery became a central point of contention between the northern and southern states, leading to conflicts such as the Missouri Compromise and the Compromise of 1850. One of the hallmarks of this period would be the Dred Scott case, in which the Supreme Court deemed that slaves and their descendants had no rights in the nation that should be respected and upheld by white citizens. Civil War and Emancipation. The American Civil War was started in 1861. And was fought primarily over the issue of slavery. A review of Confederate constitutions and speeches revealed the truth of this reality. In fact, the Confederate Vice President Alexander Stevens confirms this in his cornerstone speech, where he states, "With us, all of the white race, however high or low, rich or poor, are equal in the eye of the law. Not so with the Negro. Subordination is his place." Emancipation Proclamation was issued by President Abraham Lincoln on January 1, 1863, during the height of the Civil War, and declared the freedom of enslaved individuals in Confederate-held territories. This single moment would lead to the creation of future legislation that would establish the political rights of American freedmen. Post-Civil War Reconstruction. With the ratification of the 13th Amendment in 1865, slavery was officially abolished in the United States. The period of Reconstruction would last from 1865 to 1877 and aim to integrate those who were no longer enslaved in their progeny into American society. This effort faced numerous challenges and ultimately fell short of creating lasting equality. Now, who are the American freedmen? The term American freedmen historically refers to the formerly enslaved individuals in the United States who gained their freedom following the abolition of slavery. Prior to the abolition of slavery, African Americans in the United States were considered property and had no rights under the laws of the land. To reverse the status of slave and all disadvantages linked to it, the political term freedman would be adopted to combat the stains and former status of enslavement. The term American freedman was first used in March 1863 during the establishment of the American Freedmen's Inquiry Commission. The American Freedmen's Inquiry Commission was created by U.S. Secretary of War Edwin McMaster Stanton. Its goal was to investigate the status of the enslaved and formerly enslaved who were freed by the Emancipation Proclamation. This inquiry commission would lead to the establishment of the Freedmen's Bureau and additional protections for those who were once enslaved and their progeny. After the Civil War, the American freedmen faced numerous challenges as they sought to establish new lives as free citizens. Many were in economic straits, lacked education, and had to confront systemic racism and discrimination daily. Understanding the historical context of chattel slavery is crucial to comprehend the challenges and injustices faced by American freedmen. How many freedmen were there in comparison to other black people in the USA? It's challenging to provide precise numbers for the population of freedmen immediately after the Civil War, as historical records are not always complete or accurate. However, according to estimates, by the end of the Civil War in 1865, there were approximately 4 million newly freed African Americans in the United States. In fact, in the 1860 census, it was documented that those who were enslaved accounted for more than 85% of the total black population. In the years following the war and abolition of slavery, the freedmen's population continued to grow, especially with the birth of new generations. By the late 19th century, the freedmen and their descendants made up a significant portion of the African American population in the United States. As the 20th century progressed, the overall African American population in the United States continued to increase due to both natural growth and migration from rural areas to urban centers. Today, American freedmen still make up majority of the African American population, and at the core of all African American politics is the history linked to American chattel slavery and what occurs after its abolition. Why is the term important? The term American freedman is important because it links the descendants of persons who were enslaved in the United States directly to the Civil War, Reconstruction, and the promise of equality and justice. From a political lens, the term American freedman is at the epicenter of all legislation created to combat and destroy the lingering consequences and effects of the institution of slavery. In the contemporary reparations movement, this term has been revived to advocate for reparatory legislation and protections that have been long denied. It is our hope that under this term, we are able to achieve what has been denied to our ancestors generation after generation. Now, let's do a recap. Who are the American freedmen? The American freedmen are persons who were freed from slavery and their descendants. Who does the term apply to? The term applies to all African Americans who can trace their lineage to persons who were enslaved in the United States of America. Why is the term important? The importance of the term is directly linked to an extensive history and reparative justice initiatives concerning American chattel slavery, peonage, Jim Crow, and wealth inequality. With that, we conclude our lesson and hope that you are able to learn at a high level who the American freedmen are. Please do more research on the term American freedmen and its connections to both the history of American chattel slavery as well as those persons who were formerly enslaved. Documents can be found at your local library, the Library of Congress, and the Federal Archives.